7 years ago, World Health Organization designated shift work as a potential carcinogen. And that was a turning point in circadian rhythm research in cancer. We knew that people who do shift work, they go back and forth between shifts, and they're more predisposed to cancer. Almost every cell in our body has a circadian clock. And circadian clocks actually bring what we call the natural checks and balances to how the cell function, so that the cell can remain healthy and it will grow at the right time, it will divide and multiply when the time is right. So as you can see, when the circadian clock breaks down, cancer can grow. So it creates the perfect situation for tumor cells to grow. Gabriele, who is in my lab, thought of using some of the drugs that are already out there against circadian clock. And these drugs are not used to treat cancer. These drugs are essentially used to figure out how the clock works. So we wanted to see if we put these drugs and reactivate the cellular discipline that comes from circadian clock, then what happens to the tumor? And surprisingly, what we found is the tumor cells did not like the checks and balances of circadian clock, so they died. Whereas the nearby cells, the healthy cells that normally are used to the checks and balances of circadian clock, they didn't have any difficulty coping with the new drug because they're already used to having a circadian clock. So that means, irrespective of what the origin of the cancer may be, if we can bring back some of the disciplines of the clock by putting a drug, we can treat many different types of cancer. We subjected breast cancer cell line, colon cancer cell line, skin cancer, even glioblastoma, and the drug was very effective in killing all these types of cancers.
Glioblastoma is a tumor of the brain. It's the most common form of brain tumors in adults. Joe Biden's son and Ed Kennedy, and now Senator McCain, they all have glioblastomas. It's a pretty lethal form of tumor. There hasn't been much improvement in the outcome of the disease in terms of survival. So any new therapy or entity that can influence the outcome of this disease is really viewed extremely positively.
In a given year, 10 to 15 million new patients are diagnosed with cancer. So that's why we're really excited that this, in my lifetime, will have an impact on treating cancer.